Joining me now by Skype is Marjorie Dannenfelser, president of the Susan B. Anthony List and one of the pro-life leaders who signed that letter. Marjorie, welcome back to the show and so good to see you.
It's great to be here with you, in quotes.
Marjorie, in your letter, you say that the abortion industry is, quote, compounding one crisis with another. How do you think Planned Parenthood in particular is exploiting this situation?
Well, they really are the wolf at the door in the time of crisis. And at a time when everyone is trying to do everything that they can to be healthy and safe, they are really going in for the kill, literally, and trying to take advantage of the fact that we're sending a lot of money out to the country in emergency funding, trying to get a hold of some of that money to help circumvent the Hyde Amendment and fund abortion at a time when they think maybe nobody's paying attention. But the reality is the pro-life movement is paying attention, and we're not going to let it happen.
Marjorie, can you talk a little bit more about how this is putting women at risk?
Yeah, so as every good governor is starting to do, they're requesting that Planned Parenthoods and clinics all across the country close so that people around the country have access to emergency funding, emergency services that they need. So it's people at risk who need healthcare workers that have all the supplies that they need, have the places that when we get to a really critical place and we need more beds, we need more PPEs, the things that health workers need, well, they're not going to have them if they're being hoarded by the abortion industry. So this not just only puts women at risk, it puts everyone at risk. It also puts some of our most fundamental pro-life policies at risk unless we're paying attention, like the fetal tissue research policy and several others that this administration has laid down the law on.
Marjorie, what would you like to see the Trump administration do in this situation?
Well, I really want them to do what they actually are doing. I believe that letter that we sent over 50 organizations speaking in one voice, and then that letter also going across the country and echoing across state legislatures, we want them to be as vigilant as we are. And I believe that is the case. Sometimes in a moment of crisis, when you're really trying to just get your mind around and your energy around handling the crisis, it can be easy to miss what is happening in the periphery with that wolf at the door that Planned Parenthood is. Paying attention, keeping their eye on the prize, making sure no funding goes to any abortion clinics, pretending to be helping in a crisis when they're actually hurting in a crisis, not letting our fetal tissue policy get undermined in any way, and also making sure that chemical abortions are not being ramped up at the loneliest place that you can possibly be in a lonely time in isolation. And telemedicine can't be a part of pressing chemical abortions alone at home for women.
Marjorie, thank you so much for your insight. Thank you for what you do, and thanks for joining us. We appreciate it. Marjorie Dannenfelser, president of the Susan B. Anthony List.
Thank you.